Hello students, let's move for the next part in the lesson periodic classification of elements. Yesterday we are discussing about the De Bruyne's law of triads. Today we have to know about the limitations of De Bruyne. De Bruyne, okay, he told to want to divide the people or arrange the elements based on triads, but this what are the limitations? Limitation in the sense that disadvantages, limitations in the sense disadvantages of De Bruyne's law of triads. So like that, what the triads has given based on that, it's not applicable for all the elements. That De Bruyne's law of triads, it is not applicable for all the elements. Only he has making some group of triads, the remaining elements he himself doesn't know where to arrange. Okay, so that's why it's not applicable. I mean, based on this triads, all the elements are not arranged in the triad form. And for very low mass like hydrogen and very high mass like uranium, okay, elements they are not, this law for the very lowest mass and very highest mass elements, this law was not applicable because it is not considerable. Okay, it has not giving a tally in the sense it's not matched with the middle element. Yesterday only we got confusions about the in this thing only, that is the sodium, potassium and argon, it's not matched. 31 to nearly the difference will be 12-13, like that it should be. Okay, it's not matched with the all the elements, very high mass and the very lowest mass, it's not applicable. These are the limitations we can take. Which are those? One limitation is the all the elements are not arranged in the triad form, only in the periodic elements. And for the very lowest mass and very highest mass, this law was not applicable. See, these are the limitations we can give for the De Bruyne law of triads. Yes, yesterday due to the some not available of the periodic table, I didn't teach you how to make a period and the group, or how the elements are arranged based on periods and the group in a periodic table. So let us know about that today. So if this is called as the periodic table, so modern periodic table, this is called as the modern periodic table. I told you the the horizontal rows what are there, they are called as the periods, and these vertical columns are called as the groups. Okay, keep in mind. And there are 7 periods we can see, 1, 2, and you can also see in your textbook, this is the 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. There are the 7 periods. Okay, you can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and columns are 1, 2, 3, 4, like that up to 18 columns. Okay, up to 18 columns there will be the columns or groups. The horizontal rows are called as the periods. There are the 7 periods, they only as mentioned. And the vertical columns are called as the group. There are the total 18 groups in the periodic. Why these elements are kept in that period only, is they are did correctly or not, let us check first. Yesterday I taught you the hydrogen is placed in a first period and first group only. Then in the same way, the lithium has placed in the second period and the third group. So why lithium want to place in a second period and the third group, let us check that. So lithium atomic number will be 3 and the mass number is 6.9. You can see here it is a 6.9. so let us take that lithium. Okay, let's write the electronic configuration for the lithium. Lithium electronic configuration is, atomic number is I told you already, that is the 3, and the mass number is 6.9, in the sense approximately it is 7. Okay, so for the atomic number we want to write the electronic configuration, 1s1 and next 1s after 2s, 1s2, 2s1, 1s2, 2s1, because the maximum electron filled in the s orbit is 2, and here only it want to match for the atomic number, that is 2s1. So this comes in the it comes in the form of sorry, last orbit is second, so that's why it should be in the second period. It should, sorry, 1s2, 2s1. So yes, it is in the second period. You can check that second period, and it is also in the form of ns1. I told you the electronic configuration is ends with ns2 form. Should write that the electronic configuration ends with ns1 form, then the group is okay, then the group is first group. Okay, if the electronic configuration ends with ns2 form, then the group is second group, then the group is 2. So you can check here, the lithium comes under, even a hydrogen also ends with ns1, that's why hydrogen group is 1, and the lithium group is also 1. You can check second period and the group 1. So we can write here, this is the second period and the lithium group is 1, first group. You have to note down this table. The last orbit is its period and in this form. If the electronic configuration ends with ns1, the group is 1. If the electronic configuration ends with ns2, the group is 2. In the same way, you have to note down this table. It is very easy for you. If the electronic configuration, easy means electronic configuration, ends with ns2 np1, then the group is 3, I mean group, third group it is. In the same way, if the electronic configuration, you can write it is here, if the, it is the same. If the electronic configuration ends with ns2 np2 form, n in the sense number of period, number of period or number of orbit, we can take as number of orbit also, ns2 np2, then the group is fourth group. Then the group is fourth group. In the same way, if the electronic configuration ends with ns2 np3, then the group is fifth group. Okay, and in the same way, if the electronic configuration ends with ns2 np4, then the group is sixth group. Then the group is sixth group. And if the electronic configuration ends with ns2 np5, then the group is seventh group. If the electronic configuration ends with ns2 np6, if the electronic configuration ends with ns2 np6, then the group is eighth group. In the same way, if the electronic configuration ends with ns2 n-1 and d6, that is called as the group is ninth group. Note down, it is the ninth group. Okay, in the same way, if the electronic configuration ends with, that is the ns2 n-1, then it is called as the 10th group. Next, if the electronic configuration ends with ns1 n-1 and d10, then it is called as the 11th group. If the electronic configuration ends with ns2 n-1 and d1, so this is called as the 13th group. If the electronic configuration ends with ns2 n-1 and d2, then it is called as the 14th group. If the electronic configuration ends with ns2 n-1 d3, then it is called as the 15th group element. If the electronic configuration ends with ns2 n minus 1 and d4, then it is called as the 16th group element. Okay, or it is ends, or also it is ends with ns1 n minus 1 d5. If it is in the form, in this form, that is called as the 16th group. If the electronic configuration ends with ns2 n minus 1 and d5, then it is called as the 17th group. And if the electronic configuration ends with ns2 np6, then it is called as the 18th group element. Okay, this is called as the 18th group elements. So like the totally it is divided for the 18th group. Keep in mind, totally it is divided for how many groups? 18th group. Let us check any one or two in this. So, and you have to note down this period. If the electronic configuration ends with ns1, group 1, ns2, group 2. So like that it will continue up to 18th group. Totally 18 groups are there up to this edge. I will end that. So, and you can check that it is true or false. Let us check today some periods and some groups elements. So let us take copper. Let us take copper. Copper is Cu. Cu atomic number. Atomic number is 29 and the mass number is 64. Okay. Mass number is 63.5. But we can round up that is a 64 mass number. Always the atomic number we want to write in the left. Okay. Down of the left side of an element. And mass number we want to write to the up of the right side of an element. Okay. So let us write the electronic configuration. Electronic configuration table, you know that. 1s, 2s, then 2p and 3s, 3p, 3d. If you don't know, you have to write that. 4s, 4p, 4d and 4f. Then 5s, 5p, 5d it is. Then 6s, 6p and 5f it is. Both want to equally. 6s, 6p, 6d, 7s, 7p and 8s. So draw a line, a slanting line it is. Slanting line is also very important here. Okay, like that you have to draw the slanting line. So next you have to write the electronic configuration for the copper. Copper in the sense, first it is 1s2. So a big element only I have taken to check and to show you. Then 2s2. Then 2s after 2p6 and 3s2. 3s after 3p. Want to comes in this way only. 3p and 4s. That is the 3p6 and 4s2. Then 3p after it should be. 3p after 4s only. Next we have to move for the 3d. How the slanting line is there? That thing. 3d 10. Last maximum electron filled in the d orbit is 10. And p orbit is 6. Keep in mind. Let's count this. 2 plus 2 4, 4 plus 6 10 and 10 20, 20 plus 10 30. So it is more, so that's why we have to take 3d 9 it is, because atomic number is 29 only. So 10, 20 and 29, the atomic number, it is matched, the electrons should be matched with this. So let us check this. This is first we have to arrange in order. Arrange in the order only. So let's arrange in the order first. So if we are going to arrange this thing, so let us check that 1s2, 2s2, then 2p6 and 3s2, 3p6, 3p after one more is there, that is the 3d9 and 4s2. 4s2, in this order only we want to arrange. So this is the first orbit and this is second orbit and it is the third orbit and it is the fourth orbit. Okay, this is third and this is second and this is first. Okay, the last orbit, it should be the period of this. The period is, last orbit is 4, that's why period is 4. And let us check the group. Group in the sense, I told you already, so you can check in this it is in the form of, okay, it is in the form of n minus 1 and d9. You can check in this. Okay, so this is in the form of ns1. See, you have to take ns1 n minus 1 and d10. So if we are taken in this, actually it comes in the 11th group. Why it should be ns1 in the sense, so you can check here n minus 1 in the sense we are taken a 4s2 and 3d9. One orbit should be minus it is, so it comes in the form of ns1 n minus 1 and d last should be 9 it is, okay. So that comes in the group of 11th, okay. It should be in a group 11th, okay. Here you can check 3, it should be one orbit will be less, that's why we have taken the n minus 1, okay. That's why we have taken a n minus 1 and d9, that is in the 11th group, okay. So this is the way of finding the electronic configuration. Let us check one more, the last one. Okay, if we are taken the oxygen atomic number is 8 and the mass number is 16. So I think I told you this group is 11 and the period 4. You can check that copper group is period is 4 and the group is 11th group. Let's check for the oxygen atomic number is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p, 2 plus 2 4 2p4, enough it is, okay. 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. So this is the first period and this is the second period, okay. So that's why the period is, sorry, first orbit and the second orbit, last orbit is second, so that's why period is second period. And the group, it is ends with the form of ns2 np4, so you can check in this table ns2 np4, it is in the sixth group. Oxygen is in the sixth group or 16th group, we can take this thing also, ns2 np4, it is in the 16th group. So see, you can see here oxygen is in the 16th group. Oxygen is in which group? 16th group. Hope you will understand this. Thank you.